Hello everyone, this is Sudipta from Technical Potpourri and welcome to another video from Salesforce. So today I'm going to talk about a new feature which came live in summer 24 release. And with this feature, you have the option to evaluate your dynamic formulas right in your Apex code. So without any further delay, let's understand this feature in detail. So let's understand what is this dynamic formula all about. So when we are in Salesforce, sometimes we create formulas inside an object. For example, to check whether an opportunity amount is greater than 100K or whether an account is having a proper address defined or whether an account belongs to AMA region or APAC region. So this type of formula will check and we create the formula inside that object. Also, when we talk about formula field, there are certain limits and restrictions that we need to remember. I'll put the link of this page in the description of this video so that you know what are the different limits and restrictions around formula fields. But this dynamic formula is all about you will not create a formula inside an object. Rather, you will create a formula right inside your Apex class and then you will evaluate that formula based on the record that is being passed to the process. So one thing that you need to remember is that when you create a formula field inside an object, it means all the records from that object will be evaluated against that formula field. So if you create a formula field in opportunity object, it means all the opportunity record, be it like 10K, 1000K, 1 million, 2 million, all the opportunity records will be evaluated against that formula field, which sometimes is not necessary. You want to only evaluate a particular record from an object. So in that case, dynamic formula is a good candidate where you will not create a formula inside the object. Rather, you will create the formula right inside in the Apex class and then whatever record is being passed to the Apex class will be evaluated against that formula field. So it's not all record from that object will be evaluated. Rather, whatever record will be passed to the Apex class, only that record will be evaluated against that formula. So it's a much improved process and it gives a lot of flexibility that you don't need to create a formula field inside your object. Rather, you can dynamically create the formula field inside the Apex class. So let's see an example Apex class where I have created a formula field. So let's go back to my Visual Studio code. So here is a class that I've written. So first thing is basically a method, which is basically opportunity checker. It's a public void opportunity checker method. And here I'm passing opportunity ID. So first thing I'm doing is that with that opportunity ID, I'm fetching the opportunity record and some attributes from the opportunity record. For example, ID, amount, expected revenue, and probability. So these are the four information I'm fetching from the opportunity record. With that, I'm putting a expression, which is basically the formula expression, and the expression is basically if the amount is greater than 10,000 and the probability is greater than 50% or 0.5 and the expected revenue is greater than 20,000 or the probability is greater than 80% or 0.8. So if one of these conditions satisfies, then I want the return value as true, otherwise the return value is false. So the first thing with that I'm doing is basically I'm instantiating a formula builder. The comment for that is formulaBuild. This is the instance variable name and the method is formula.builder. With this method, I need to pass few information. First information is like what type of record this formula is expecting. Definitely, I'll be passing opportunity record. So which type? I'm giving opportunity.as object type. Then what will be the return type of the formula? The return type of the formula in my case is Boolean. So that's why I'm putting with return type as formula return type dot boolean. And finally, what is the exact formula? So I've written the formula inside this formula expression, which I will be passed in this with formula expression. So this will basically instantiate a formula builder and then with proper parameters like what type of record it can expect, what will be the return type and what is the exact formula. With that, I am going to use the build method, which is basically giving me an instance of formula instance. And with that, what I'm going to do with this instance variable, I am going to call the function called evaluate. And inside this evaluate function, I'm going to pass the actual record which I want to evaluate against this particular formula expression. So the record is single op, which I've fetched at the beginning of this method. And then I'm passing that. And then this will return me a Boolean, which I'm storing inside this Boolean variable called formula outcome. And finally, in the system.debug, I am putting this formula result, which is formula outcome. So this is the method that I've written. Let's execute that method in the Salesforce org. So let's go back to the Salesforce org. So here I am in my Salesforce org. Let's go to the developer console and execute this anonymous method. So here I'll first pass opportunity ID. So let's copy this opportunity ID, put it here, and let's do execute. And let's see the result. So the result is coming as true. The reason is, if I go to the details section, the amount is definitely greater than 30,000 and the probability is 100%, which is greater than 50%, and expected revenue is 30,000 and probability is 100%. So let's change something. Let's change the probability to 30%. And let's execute the same function again. Let's open that. And this time, as you can see, it's coming as false because now the probability is 30%. And as per this formula, it has to be greater than either 50% or 80%. But actually, the probability is 30%. So that's why it's giving result as false. This is a way how you can create your dynamic formula inside your Apex class and then pass your Salesforce record to get it evaluated against that formula. So I think this is a powerful feature. And we should all use that because now we don't need to unnecessarily create a formula field and get it evaluated against all the records from that object. Rather, we can create this dynamic formula and take a good advantage of this in our Apex class. So that's all for today. I hope you like this video. If you like this video, please hit the like icon. Please share this video with your friends, with your colleagues so that they know about this powerful feature and they can take advantage of this in their daily life when they do the programming. And finally, if you like this video, please subscribe to my channel so that you came to know about all my upcoming videos. In next couple of days, I'll be publishing more contents on Google Cloud, on Salesforce. So if you are subscribed, you'll be the first person to get notified the moment I publish a new video. But till then, stay safe and thank you.